Ezreal, and this right. will disorient the engage of Space Gamer Calyx if they overextend, because they also have the Camille here to go to the carries of Space Gamer Calyx, but right. will they Olaf yeah. again?
We forgot about that Olaf. We yeah, forgot about the old man Olaf.
Old man Olaf charging in once again with that Ragnarok.
Right.
Axe per axe, undertow, true damage, lifesteal. That is a very hard champion to kill.
Alright, let's see. They don't have a hard counter for the Olaf. No Darius, no Garen. So yeah, this is gonna be a good Olaf game for Calyx. Let's see how this is gonna go through. I like the picks of both teams as of the moment. I like it. Let's see who will win this. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to game 3. Welcome to Wild Rift. This is championship match. Whoever wins this will get Minions crowned. Let's go. One Snap Esports going up against Calyx Space Gaming. One Snap Esports Femme Fatale team, their female team. And let's go. Brother G, are you able to see the screen right now? Can you introduce
it's the blue kind side? Of a challenge, but let's see. We have the Camille in the top lane, Wukong in the jungle, Orianna in the mid lane, and for our dragon laners, we have the Ezreal and the Braum. Very safe pick here for OnSnap Esports.
It's quite challenging here on my end too. It's like watching Minecraft. everything is a box, but I can see Aurelio Sol is in the mid right here. Olaf is at the top. It is going to be Jarvan 4 for the jungler for the red side. Calyx, Kai'Sa on the ADR, and then Gambling X on the Alistar. It's going to be an early fight here in the middle. Orianna is already very low. Has to be careful right here, and both are done with those spokes. Let's see how this is going to move forward.
Yeah, very aggressive playstyle here for both mid laners. They're both chunked down to minimal health, so that attracts the junglers, that attracts the dragon laners as well to try and get a kill onto their enemy mid laner. But let's see, because top lane is a very interesting lane as well. The Camille Olaf matchup is always something to look forward to seeing because of the playstyle of both champions, Camille being an engaged champion and Olaf as well being an engaged, but it's right. more advantage to him when the enemy team engages.
Right.
Riftscutter just has that
Ragnarok. Right. Riftscutter just got taken on the bottom side. So that's one Riftscutter on both sides at the top. Again, it's gonna be interesting to look at the Camille and Olaf. Camille being a flashy champion on the entrance. Olaf pretty straightforward as a champion, but very powerful as it is. Here we go. Up. There's gonna be a clash right here. I think two red champions are rotating here in the mid. It's not yet time for the dragon, so I don't know what the plan was. Maybe they dropped a ward somewhere. Nope. Oh, initiation right here is not gonna hit. Ezreal's ready for that, but it's get hit with 30 skill of Kai'Sa. Ezreal better be careful right here. We'll have to eat the fruit to survive because Braum was not there. Bakit may iniwan Braum? Braum is here now, so Ezreal is safe.
A good rotation here coming in from Space Gamer Calyx. Establishing vision over the dragon pit, even on some of the red side jungle of OneSnap Esports, and they were the ones who arrived in the bottom lane first to get that pressure onto the Ezreal because of that damage from that Kai'Sa with a Void Rush, a Void Seeker. So that's a really good trade by them. And forcing the Honeyfruit taken will allow them to have that advantage. Although they have taken the Honeyfruit off their side, so they don't have that healing anymore, but they are relatively healthy.
True, man. The warding of Calyx right now onto the dragon side is very good. They will know if ever someone rotates or try to set up for this dragon, as the dragon timer is already right here. 0-0 on the scoreboard. Still pretty peaceful as of the moment, but that Infernal Drake will most probably break the status quo of the game right now. 26 seconds. It's going to be the Infernal Dragon that is going to spawn.
Yeah, Infernal Dragon here. Spawning in just 15 seconds. Let's see which team will arrive in this location first, because we're seeing resets now coming in from Space Gamer Calyx. Meanwhile, in the top lane, some tradings are being done here by both top laners. And since the Dragunov spawn supports here are going to say hi to each other as they establish vision control over this objective, that's going to be the scuttle crab taken here by Space Gamer Kallax to gain that movement speed advantage, to gain that vision control over this objective. Nice poke, by the way, by the Orianna onto this Aurelion Sol. And with that burst damage, he will have a little bit of a hard time going to the Dragon Pit because of the zoning potential of this Orianna. And as the Olaf resets now, the Camille also resets, they will charge on to this objective to gain this dragon stack.
Alright, Orianna will have to reset also. She's very low in mana right now. If our red team knows about this, they can start a dragon already. But, oh, no, everyone is gonna play this. Say if this is game number 3, mind you, every stake right here is gonna be very costly. So everyone is gonna be very methodical at this point on, and we're just gonna have a high level gaming in front of us, which is good for us viewers, diba?
Yeah, very nice for us viewers. Very safe play by both teams. No deaths, no kills so far. Dragon is kind of lonely right now. He's saying, please attack me, please give me attention. But no, both teams want to gain advantage first before they start this objective, because once they take on this dragon, there's going to be a guaranteed team fight, and they don't want to have any control of the enemy team, any advantage at all, because this is the last, the final game, and whoever wins in this tournament will be the grand champions of the Ranmen tournament. And let's see here, we're Flash, seeing an engage here by the Wukong, getting that first blood onto the Aurelion Sol, and this gives them the advantage they needed to secure this Infernal Dragon. This is actually very big for their team, but we're seeing the Jarvan hovering here, trying to get a steal here with the Flag and Drag. Cataclysm being used here, the Shockwave used defensively, but it's going to be one snap Esports securing this dragon, plus a kill on the Jarvan. Space Gamer Kallax are now disengaging after losing two members in that team fight, with the Aurelion Sol a while ago being picked up as well. So that is a huge lead for OneSnap Esports, extending their gold lead now to almost 3,000 gold.
And they're not done yet, man. OneSnap Esports, Vambi getting the Drake right there and getting the kill on the Jarvan 4 is already up, starting the Shelly earlier, but he will opt for a back. And while everyone is going to go for a reset. Man, it's a 3k gold lead onto OneSnap Esports. Good job by the team securing this early lead in this early part of the game. But it's not over yet. This is just an early game lead. Things can still be reversed right here. Mm-hmm. Let's see how Kallax Gaming is going to be able to reverse that. Just like that. They find an opening right there on the Orianna.
Oh,
Orianna
still alive! Out.
But good shield right there by Orianna. Somehow escapes with her slip of life, finds an opening and says, see you later, alligator. But this is
how
an opening.
How did he survive that gank, that shield, that barrier? What an insane play by that Orianna. And now they pop the GA. Okay, that's an engage once again. GA has been popped here. Boom. For the Wukong. The Cyclone being used. Brom here gets taken down. Same with the Wukong. That is a go signal now for Space Gamer Kallax to secure this Rift Herald after that early mishap on the Aurelion Sol. Nice stun here onto the Ezreal. He's being zoned out a little bit, but they have to respect that damage. They have to respect the mobility of this champion. They can actually turn the tides around even with just the Ezreal. So they will back away for now. Be happy with the two kills picked up by their team and cash in for their items.
Right. So far, so good for both teams. Pretty even game. It is going to be blue team with a 2k gold lead still. Earlier, they let the Orianna live, but on the second engage that they have, they've made sure that they are going to be able to finish the job. Two champions going down onto the blue side after that, evening the board, and we have a 2-for-2 right now. Mid-third, First turret goes down at the top. That's going to be extra gold for the blue side right here. We are now seeing the lead balloon up to 3K. Will OneSnap Esports be able to take care of this lead and make it a snowball later part in the game? It's not going to be an easy task, but let's see if they were able to do that.
Yeah, Cyclone has been invested here by the Wukong, so he doesn't have that crowd control for their kit, but they will secure this Rift Herald, and Space Gamer Kalex are now starting this team fight. They managed to steal the Rift Herald. Nice shockwave though by the Orianna, forcing the Kaiser to back away. However, Wukong has been slain. The Olaf now just charging in, getting two kills. In the end, he will die. And now it's time for OneSnap Esports to get kills of their own, securing three kills in exchange for two.
3-for-3 exchange right there. Good job by OneSnap Esports. But in the end, that clash was really for the take of the of the Rift Herald, and it is going to be Kalex who gets the Rift Herald. With that in mind, they can use it for the next objective of this game, which is going to be spawning in the next 15 seconds of the game. Let's see what they are going to be doing with this Rift Herald. Mid turret of the red side is down. That's good for blue side, extending their lead. We now have a 5k gold lead 10 minutes into the game. OneSnap Esports, so far so good.
Yeah, so far so good, but we're seeing a death brush being set up here by OneSnap Esports. This is very deadly. They can actually engage onto them if they get the perfect timing. However, Space Gamer Kalex are not letting them. They're rotating onto the bot side of the map. Dragon is still not being started here. They will look to shove the wave in the mid lane and in the bot lane first, but Wukong and Orianna are already starting this dragon. They got spot out by the Alistar, so this will be very difficult. Voidseeker has hit the Wukong, so repositioning from the Kai'Sa is very possible. Headbutt, pulverize onto 3. The flag and drag here. Glacial Fissure being used. The Cyclone here desperately used. The Jarvan falls down. The Wukong has been slain. The Olaf is just rampaging all over that team fight, and that will be 4 kills picked up. The Camille is remaining alive, but it is very scary for him to engage right now because he was late in the fight. And the Rift Herald now has been spawned in the bottom lane. They will not secure the tower for now. They will look to reset and cash in gold before they go to the dragon. But that clash was so huge. 4 kills, and the gold lead has been reduced to a little over 2,000 now.
All right, Kalex, Space Gamers takes the fight onto the faces of blue side. 4 champions going down. That is going to be them cutting the lead down to 2K. It's still OneSnap Esports right here on top of the game. But right now, Kalex has the momentum. Let's see what they can do about this. Dragon was not taken right there, so it's still available for the taking. Let's see if Kalex is going to go for it this time. It's not very high in the priority right now. Oops, Olaf is going to be initiated on. Takes so much damage right there. Olaf is in no position to fight. Almost got taken by that, was that Perseverance, right?
Yeah, True Shot Barrage is available. They're not investing it onto the Olaf, so he will be able to disengage successfully. The Dragon will be started here. Headbutt pulverized into that unbreakable will, but the Wombo combo by OneSnap Esports are just damaging the backline right now. They managed to break the Olaf, and now the Camille being here in this team fight will allow them to win right now. 4 kills picked up by them after them losing 4 members a while ago. Is their revenge right now.
Yes, claps back. OneSnap Esports claps back and claps back hard onto Kalex. They get their own quad kill for the team fight right there and gets the dragon under their buckets, and then plus the turret on the bottom side, furthering their lead back up to 7k already. This is bigger than earlier before. So OneSnap Esports is in a good position of this game. Baron is already alive. Divine will try to check it out. Doesn't know about this red buff take, and that's red buff going onto the Camille.
Yeah, a while ago it was just 2,000 gold lead after that 4 kills picked up by Space Gamer Kalex, and now it has ballooned to 7,000 gold now for OneSnap Esports, and that is huge because this gives them the snowball they need, the itemization they need to have this advantage in terms of team fights, in terms of objective controls, and in terms of pressuring all over the map. Even the Camille now will have reduced trouble against the Olaf because of this item that he has, and we're seeing it now. That damage is insane. Olaf, no problem. I'm Camille with 7,000 gold lead from my team. We have no problem with Olaf now. We will thrive and survive this composition, and we will
shockwave
to engage onto them with that shockwave, shocking them so much as they attempt to take this Baron, but they will not falter here. That's going to be engaged here by this Alistar. That's going to be the Baron picked up here by which team? I'm not seeing it. It's going to be picked
Red team.
Up by Space Gamer Kalex, and now they're fleeing from One Stop Esports. Aurelion Soul gets bursted down by the Ezreal, a triple kill by Doidoy DR in this team fight. They managed to pick up the Baron, but they lost three members, and One Snap Esports are angry at this. They want to punish them with two towers falling down instantaneously with their damage. And this will be such a huge gold lead by them. 13,000 gold lead here for One Snap Esports. That is huge.
Yeah, that's a very good play by Kalex right there, sacrificing their life for the Baron, man. That will extend this game and give them an opening for a comeback right here. They are down for a very big amount, and extending this this game will most probably give them an opening later on. We will know for sure as Kalex will try their best to get back in this game. And may nag-comment dito kanina RV Vival, but nag-shoutcaster na to si Lloyd Bazaar. Man, living the dream, living the dream.
Living the dream, man. Yeah.
Dream ko to noon pa. Alright, let's go, let's go. OneSnap Esports not yet done. They can still feel the anger that they have, the emotions that they have when the Baron buff was stolen right under their noses. They're gonna go for this preparation for this dragon, an elder dragon of the game. We're already 16 minutes into the game, and this lead they have, they can go aggressive as much as they want to.
Mountain Infernal Dragon, so increased durability and increased in damage. That is huge for their team. If they get this, the Olaf will no longer be able to pressure at all. We're seeing an engage now by the Aurelion Soul Headbutt, pulverize onto two flag and drag. Cataclysm is available. They're trying to kite out here, but the crowd control coming in here from Space Gamer Kalex is just enough to pop the GA. But the Killer Instinct being used here by the Kaiser, trying to zone out every single one, dealing so much damage. Olaf here charging in, but it's going to be the Elder Dragon secured here.
Rampage.
By OneSnap Esports, and with that they will just melt every single one of Space Gamer Kalex. It's only the Jarvan remaining alive, but it won't matter now as OneSnap Esports looking to make their march now to get this win, to become the grand finals of this tournament. Congratulations, OneSnap Esports, securing 2-for-1 and becoming the champions of this tournament.
And look at those faces, the face of victory. Sabi nga nila, ngiting wagi, Philippines winning this fight. Good job, OneSnap Esports. Hard fought battle, and in the end, it was all